put the place up. Don't we know what we made of? Can't get enough for you, boy. I'm a chaser. Face up, now I feel no major. Keep up and out, ego, I'm a taker. Welcome back, everybody, to a lovely but insanely hot and humid night out here on the dock. I'm probably going to sweat all over this rifle throughout the review, but as you probably guessed from the title and the thumbnail, we are going over this rifle that you see in front of you. It is the STAG 3-gun, STAG 15, I believe they call it 3-gun. And basically, this is one of their newest offerings. This is the traditional version, I guess we'll call it. They also make a left-handed version, and then they make a band state compliant version for folks who have to deal with that nonsense. So just kind of know that we're gonna be talking about this one, but there are other versions of this rifle out there, especially for you lefties. I know you guys love your STAG rifles, so there is that. The rifle is stock with a couple exceptions. Muzzle device has been changed, vertical foregrip has been added, and optic has been added. But other than that, it is stock. But there is a reason we're talking about it today. If you guys are watching this in the first day or two after the video is released, STAG has done this rather limited edition series, We the People, here. And I can't talk about what's going on with that rifle here on YouTube, but check out my social media if you guys are watching this in the first day or two that it is being reviewed, and you guys will see some cool stuff going on regards to that limited edition rifle. But it is the same rifle, just with a We the People Cerakote job on it. So I suppose before we get into all the details of the rifle and then really what I think it's for, because obviously it's marketed for 3-gun, but I think it has some other uses that we will talk about, let's head out to the range, see what kind of accuracy you can expect out of it, and then after that we will kind of go through it piece by piece as we traditionally do with AR-15 reviews here on the channel. And at the end we'll let you know how reliable it's been and I suppose what I think of it overall. Now we're going to see what kind of groups this rifle can lay down with a few different loads. So in the gun right now we have some 45 grain jacket hollow points from Remington, so it's 223 chambering, light 4 caliber. Should note that I did remove the suppressor for this accuracy portion of the video. Some folks get mad if you use suppressors during these portions. I don't know why, but it should also give you guys an idea of how it ejects naturally without the can on there. So we're using a CTK Precision Rest Swamp Fox 1-10 scope, so plenty of magnification, and for the target downrange 100 yards. So, and then we have a super high speed sock full of sand. It's the kind of stuff you can't buy online, kids. So we'll see how it does with this load, and then test a few others, and we'll keep it moving. Let's do it. Not a bad group there. Interesting note on that is that that is the load that this rifle was zeroed with, but with the silencer on there, it's point of aim, point of impact, and we're obviously high there with that particular one without the can. So up next, again, another Remington load, with this time with the 55 grain AccuTip. So sort of a hunting type of load, and we'll see how she likes this one. And the last load up here is going to be some 77 grain. This is the AAC loading with the Sierra Match King bullet in there. So heavy 4 caliber. We'll see how she does with this load. Let's go check them out. Y'all have already seen the groups a little closer up than me with that camera, but first up was that 45 grainer. And decent looking group. And yeah, center to center, the widest that one measures out to is right at 1.5 inches with that one. Then we had our 55 grain Remington. Looks similar, but a touch wider. So on that one, we are right at 1.625 inches for that group. And then I'm assuming that's 5 rounds. I think I fired 5 rounds. And it just went through with the same hole with the 77 grainers, but that definitely tightened up a lot. So on that one, we are center to center, just over 1 inch, like 1.16 inches, if you will, center to center on that one. So definitely a decent group there, and honestly, all of them pretty good groups overall. With the accuracy out of the way, we'll start here tip to butt and work our way back. We have on here a chemo compatible muzzle device because we ran this primarily suppressed. We did run it with the brake that it comes with, which is the VG6 Gamma L, I believe. It's a perfectly functional muzzle brake, and if you guys like muzzle brakes, cool. I'm not a huge fan, you guys know that, so we swapped it out for a suppressor host. So that's what we ran primarily, but we did run it both suppressed and unsuppressed, and it ran 100% so far throughout our testing. And just round count right now, we're about 1200 rounds. And on that note, thanks to the folks at Firearms Depot for supplying the rifle ammo here on the channel. They make it possible. So continuing on back, we do have a ballistic advantage. This is a Hansen lightweight profile 416R223 wild chambered barrel. And of course, it has that continuous taper down there to the 0.625 gas block. So one of the things I really like about this rifle is that barrel system. It also has the 1-8 twist as well. And it has a lifetime warranty. So if you didn't know that, all Stag Arms rifles do. If you ever shoot your barrel out, Stag will replace it for free. I'd be willing to bet none of you ever will shoot out one of the barrels, but it's an excellent barrel, and I really, really like the profile of it. It changes the handling of the rifle in every way versus an A2. It's phenomenal. It's one of the things I really, really like about it. It's very light out front, and for competition use or tactical use for that matter, being able to drive the front end of the rifle is extremely important, and that Hansen profile has the weight where you need it back here at the rear, but doesn't have it all out on the front. I mean, excellent choice for barrel, and you guys saw the accuracy there. Obviously, if we use different loads, the results would be a little bit different, but it shoots just fine. Anything that's right at 1 MOA, I will take all day long. Continuing on to the handguard itself, it is the Atlas that several companies, Stag's parent company, makes use. It's a fantastic handguard. I actually have a dedicated review on the handguard. About 15 inches, has the M-lock slots at the 3, 6, and 9 o'clock position. Also has these large venting holes in the offset position. Some folks like offset M-lock really with the mounts that are available today. I don't really think it's a big deal, and it does, once again, help lighten up the front end of the rifle, but still give you that 15-inch real estate that a lot of folks do like. Obviously, we've been running it with this vertical hand grip here from Magpul, and again, the pointability, shootability of the rifle is excellent. It uses this locking wedge back here at the rear in conjunction with, it also has anti-rotation tabs on the side that just cover up the upper receiver. The thing's rock solid in terms of a 15-inch rail, has a very minimal flex. And I say that because, again, this rifle is marketed towards competition use, but I think it's a very good all-around rifle, period. So tactical use, whatever the case may be, if you wanted to mount lights, lasers, etc. on there. Again, very solid rail, and in terms of deflection with lasers and things like that, you really don't have to worry about it at all. The top has that 1913 rail on there, but it's, again, hollowed out in the middle to make it a little bit lighter, which, again, when with AR-15s, when you're kind of looking at different ones, having everything lightened up in the front, my opinion, is a huge win for the folks at Stag. So I suppose we'll continue on back to the receiver. Continuing on back to the upper, it is T-marked per mil spec. Additionally, the upper and lower receiver are both forged 7075 T6 with a hard anodized finish on there. Excellent in that regard. I should also note that this rifle, if you live in a normal state, does ship with a 40-round Gen M3 P-Mag, so that is a nice bonus. A lot of rifles obviously don't ship with that, and I do dig it. Once again, it is oriented for the competition market. Now, I suppose we'll pop our pins and get into the internals. And when we go to take our charging handle out, you will definitely notice it is not mil-spec in that regard. This is the breech charging handle. It's ambidextrous. And of course, it has the large latches on there. This charging handle is offered with both small and large latches, but being a competition-oriented rifle, they put on the large latches there, which I have no problem with. And then additionally, we do have this gas-busting piece back here at the rear. It mates up to where it meets the upper receiver to help prevent gas coming back in your face. Running traditional suppressors, it does help a little. It doesn't eliminate it, but it definitely helps. So we'll take it. Good upgraded feature on there. The upper receiver itself does have M4 feed ramps, which I do appreciate. Helps with feeding and reliability with all different types of ammo. Also has a forward assist, which I know some of you hate. I love tapping it, makes me happy, and it makes me feel at home. Continuing on to our bolt carrier group here. It is a full auto profile, nitrided bolt carrier group. So we have the full auto sear trip back there at the rear. And then the bolt itself is 90 310 steel, and it is MP tested. per their website, I do not believe it is HP tested. Now, again, you guys can debate that down below in the comment section whether or not it should be. I've said many times in the video that with modern materials and modern inspection processes, HP testing may be a little bit of overkill, but again, feel free to debate down below in the comment section. Has good staking there on the gas key. Overall, a very high quality item. Cannot complain about that. Let's get into our lower receiver here. So for those that don't know, STAG a few years ago moved out to Wyoming. So these are the Wyoming lowers and they're very proud of it. It's all over there. Has our STAG logo on the right side. And then of course, as well as on the left, has that Cheyenne Wyoming marking on there. One thing I like about the STAG lowers, they're similar to BCM in the fact that they are a quote unquote mil-spec dimension. So any of the aftermarket stuff you wanna use with them, you can, but they do flare the magwell more than other companies. I do like that. I think every company should do that. I don't know why every company doesn't do that, but it is a nice bonus versus say like a Colt or something like that. Continuing on back, we do have the Magpul enlarged trigger guard, Magpul K2 grip, which I really like. It is a vertical grip. It's a little bit on the larger side. It fills up your hand if you have large hands like I do. It definitely is super comfortable, and we have a helicopter flying overhead. We'll let it pass by and then come right back. That helicopter should be far enough away now that it shouldn't be an issue. Continuing on back to our safety, we have STAG's Ambi safety, which I really like. One of the better ones out there on the market. It is a 90 degree safety, but what I do like is on the offhand side. So again, this is a right-hand rifle. They make the left hand, it'll be set up the opposite way. But when you're in the firing position, you put the safety down, it is scalloped out there. So that way it's not bumping into my hand when I do that. I like that, yet it still allows me to come up with my firing finger when I'm done and put it on safe. It's something I do a lot. I've kind of grown accustomed to that. And when I fire the traditional left side only, sometimes I do that and miss it. Continuing on to the trigger, which is an upgrade over a lot of the competitive offerings out there on the market. This is the Hyperfire Hypertouch trigger. It is one of Hyperfire's more expensive models. Definitely something that STAG went a little bit beyond to put into the rifle over some of the more budget offerings. It has this trigger shoe built into the shoe. The shoe itself is flat. You can actually remove this piece if you want to, but I don't know why you would. One thing I do like about it is it gives you a very consistent finger placement, because every time your finger is going to go in the same place, so you kind of can't mess that up. And then it has a crisp, very crisp, like absolutely no movement, 3-pound brake on there. And then the reset, short, tactile, audible. Again, as soon as that trigger resets, you're back on that wall, and that is the brake. Very good. One thing I like about it versus a lot of single stage, particularly drop-in triggers, is that you can actually access everything in the trigger. So a lot of drop-in single stage match triggers will have a lot of that area covered up. And the reason I like that is that if you get a blown primer or just any sort of gunk, dirt, whatever the case may be, gets in there, you can actually fish it out if you have a tool or something like that, or you can just knock it out and let gravity do its work. So for reliability, for a duty type usage, I definitely like that versus a lot of the competitive offerings. Some people may think that 3-pound brake is a little bit on the light side for duty use. I will let you guys debate that again down below in the comment section. Of course, if you're using, you know, proper gun safety, it shouldn't be an issue at all. Moving on back to the buffer itself, it is an H buffer, and then it has your traditional 6-position carbine extension on there. It is properly staked, which I do like. And then we also have our Magpul SLS stock. So as you can see, it's wider than your traditional stock would be. And it also allows for storage. So back here at the rear, we have these two pieces that are rubber sealed on there. Let me see if I can pull it out. I think I can. There you go. You guys can see it's O-ring sealed. You can put batteries in there. You can put snacks in there. You can put Skittles in there. Whatever you want to put in there, you can do so. Then it has these two traditional sling loop attachments, and then also has our steel reinforced QD attachment point. It has that nice rubber stock, and it has that little toe angle there. So that way when you're firing in the upright position, it's a little bit more comfortable than if it was straight. I suppose with that, we've covered all of the relevant features of the rifle with one exception, of course, that is going to be price point. Before I get to that, I should note, full disclosure, STAG did send the rifle out for the review, so there is that. But it hasn't biased anything I've said in terms of reliability and accuracy. There's no way to bias that. It is what it is. And accuracy, you guys saw. Reliability, almost all of this has been fired with Igman 223 55 grain from Firearms Depot. And then you guys saw what we use for accuracy testing. It's been fired with two different suppressors, the Liberty Agent, the Dead Air Sandman K, both with this muzzle device as well as the factory brake. Again, it's been 100% reliable, so you can't be mad about that. And again, the price point comes in at MSRP at $14.99. Other places, of course, are offering it less, as you traditionally see with companies. On there, we've been running the Swamp Fox almost the whole time, 1 to 10. It's been great as well. Video will be coming on that, and I'm filming this around 4th of July, so you guys hear the fireworks in the background. But overall, I think it is an excellent rifle for just about any type of use, especially given the price point and the features that it has, as well as the weight and the handling characteristics it has. Obviously, they market it for three gun. I'm not a big competitive shooter. I think there's a lot of value in competitive shooting. So if you're into that, cool. STAG has a lot of three-gun shooters that they work with, and I'm sure worked with to develop this rifle. But I think it is a fantastic do-all rifle. I really do. I think if you get it in as it comes from the factory, again, add a optic of your choice, add a light of your choice if you're using it for that type of use. Switch out the brake for like a flash hider or even an A2. And it is a very good, you know, ranch rifle, home defense rifle, whatever the case may be, any type of use you might have. But of course, if you're shooting it competitively, the brake makes sense. You guys can debate that down below in the comment section. That is just fine, but I really like it. And again, I like that barrel profile, the barrel material, everything on there for a do-all use rifle for sure. So I think that's it. We'll close the video out. Looking forward to your comments down below. If you guys are new here, make sure you hit the subscribe button. We already talked about my social media down below. Make sure you're following me across there, because on YouTube, we tend to be censored a good bit here. It is what it is. So make sure you're following me elsewhere, so that way you guys can see my content if this place goes down. Speaking of that, we have a monthly email that goes out once a month and has nothing in it, you know, besides the video since the previous month's email went out. So that way, if you guys are subscribed and you're not seeing 2 to 4 videos a week here on the channel, we can go around the algorithm and go straight into your inbox. So make sure you sign up for that. Additionally, if this goes on sale, the optics go on sale, the ammo goes on sale, lights go on sale, suppressors go on sale, any of that stuff, it will be my daily deals email. It goes out every single day, as the name indicates. And if it's in the email, it's the best price I know of on the internet on that particular day, because I've done the price comparisons for you. So that way it saves you guys some time and hopefully saves you some money as well. We have a virtually zero unsubscribe rate, which tells me that we're providing some value to people who do subscribe to that daily deals email. So I recommend you do so. I recommend doing so with a non-Gmail account. It tends to get through at a better rate if you do that. And yeah, there's also a spicy meme in there as well, pretty much every day, that folks dig as well. So that's it. Thank you all for watching. I truly appreciate it, and I look forward to seeing each and every one of you in the next video.